Buenos días. Bienvenidos al espacio Lab de la Embajada de España ante el Reino de Bélgica. Tengo el honor de inaugurar virtualmente la exposición El estudio en el espejo de Gadea Burgaz. Gadea, buenos días y enhorabuena por esta exposición, que he tenido la gran suerte de poder visitar presencialmente y la primera sensación que he tenido es del inmenso trabajo que hay detrás de cada objeto y de cada rincón de ella. Gadea representa el testimonio vivo de la colaboración y cooperación que existe en el terreno cultural entre España y Bélgica. Gadea viene de pasar unos meses en el Centro de Arte Contemporáneo WIELS de Bruselas, gracias al apoyo de Acción Cultural Española y de esta propia embajada. Su próximo destino será ser becaria en la Real Academia Española de Roma, por lo cual te felicito en nombre de todos. Muchísimas gracias a las instituciones que han hecho posible esta exposición, esta colaboración, y muchísimas gracias a todos los que nos seguís y vais a tener la posibilidad de intervenir en esta actividad. Os dejo ya con Gadea y deseo que disfrutéis de esta exposición. Muchísimas gracias.
Buenos días. Bonjour, goeiedag. In welcome. Hello, welcome everyone. Welcome to this online presentation of El Estudio en el Espejo, The Studio in the Mirror, an exhibition by architect and artist Gadea Burgaz that I like to define as work in progress and in transition. I'm Sergi Farré, the cultural and scientific counselor at the Embassy of Spain, and we are now online streaming from the Spain Arts and Science Lab in Belgium, the lab, which is at the end. You could see when coming in, we are at the end of this courtyard of this palais, this maison de maître, this palacete, which is at the heart of the European quarter. And I'm here with my colleagues, Yurena, Jessica, and Esther, who are behind the cameras, helping make this possible. Keep tuned. And now I would like to introduce Guzmán Palacios, who is the Director of Cultural and Scientific Relations at AECID, the Spain's Agency for International Development, within our Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Madrid. He's in charge of the Ministry's International Cultural Network, which includes cultural and scientific section of this embassy, our cultural centers, mostly in Latin America and Africa. And I'm very grateful to him for taking time from his busy schedule to kind of take a peek through his online window and say a few words to us. So, Guzmán, if you're there, please, the floor is yours, as they say, or the mic is yours.
Thank you very much, Sergi. Hello, bonjour, buenos días to all of you. It's an enormous pleasure for me to be able to participate in this webinar. Sergi contacted me a couple of weeks ago, and with great it was an enormous pleasure for me to be able to be with all of you here. And I would like to congratulate especially Gadea Burgaz for this marvelous work she's been doing throughout all these years, and especially today that we're presenting our exhibit. As you know, 2020 was a horrific year for the sector of cultural sector. From my feed, as Sergi mentioned at the beginning of this webinar, art is motion, and through the new techniques which the pandemic has given us, we're going to have a view of Belgium, of Spain, through us here in Madrid, and of Rome. And I think it's a wonderful idea connecting people abroad, although we are all striving to meet each other and go back to physical presentations. But again, I would like to congratulate my colleagues in Belgium, and especially Gadea for this marvelous work she's launching today with us. So thanks again, and My pleasure.
And now we're getting to the part of the meaty part of the webinar, where we will invite Gadea to guide us through her exhibit. Let me first say a few words about her. Gadea, she's an architect by training and also an artist, as you can see. She's one of those privileged people that can dialogue, the both sides of the, both hemispheres of the brain. She's multifaceted personally, and I think this shows in her work, that's based on a constant dialogue amongst different disciplines, where she's actually waiting for her objects and the items of this exhibit to arrive, so she can proceed, on her creative journey there. Gadea, cuando quieras, un placer tenerte con nosotros. Thank you so much for being here.
Hello, hola. Hello, everybody. Thank you, all of us. All the participants that are here with me online, and thank you, Sergi and Guzman. It's the first time that I listen to someone speaking about my career. It's nice to listen to it. And I want to say also that it's the first exhibition that I do in my life about my work. So for me, it's kind of a curious experience, this, because a part of the first exhibition, I'm still experiencing the consequences of this, even if I'm in Rome, because as Sergi said, all my objects are still there. So I arrive here without them, and it's not a problem. It's very nice. Mentally, it's a good feeling, but at the same time, I have still a foot in Brussels, no, a little bit. And also, it has been curious, this exhibition, this show, because it's very related to the intimacy or the privacy that you give to someone, to the public, and you are not there. I'm not there now for explaining all these things, and I think it's a very material exhibition somehow. So it's quite strange to do it online. But let's see what happens, no? And okay. I remember opening the boxes, there was not time to think, only in 3 days. So I opened the boxes and I started to take all my objects and thinking, okay, let's do it in a very spontaneous way without thinking too much. But it was impossible at the same time, because even if you do it spontaneous, you are thinking that someone is going to see all of these things, so you have to show them. For example, this is the main entrance, and I had these objects because I also brought my papers and I don't know, some things that are super stupid somehow, no? But for me, were important in my studio, and I had them there. With this exhibition was also to think very well what to throw out, what to bring to Rome, what to bring to Madrid, what to give as a present. And that is something that everybody deal with that when there is a moving. But here it was peculiar because it's like moving plus a show plus someone that is going to pack without me. So I tried to put a lot of stickers in all the objects that you can see in the room, like where there is written for WIELS. So I had this paper there, and with the filter, it's very difficult to see, but it's a paper with two layers that when you see with the red filter, you can see Versailles. In the last days, I went back home one day and I found old women, Belgian women, cleaning the floor of the street with this mechanism. And it's something that I have been working on and doing videos. So let's see. Well, this is a future project, maybe. If we could keep on going, we arrived to this table that it's, I brought the carpet from WIELS, and I have here a very rudimentary loom that I had at the beginning of the residency, because I start weaving the screen, and they asked me to put my digital projects from the past, no? But I thought, okay, instead of showing my past projects, I'm going to do something else with videos, because I was here in Rome and I had to send this video for the screen, and I thought, no, maybe it's better to take my videos of the phone. That is something very, I had a lot of boxes, so, and I had these tables from the embassy, no? So I dispose, I thought, okay, let's use the tables that they have, and I dispose everything by boxes. This is the box 4 with some exceptions. And there are a lot of little things. And I decided with Agatha, there is one friend that came with me to help me the second day, we decided to put the paper in the tables and write a lot of little things, no? I wrote many indications of how to pack the material, and also some notes about what is something, what is not. I don't know, the latte space. I was trying to tell little stories, no, to the public. And here I have a lot of material that it's very, very special material, and I'm super, it's related with Francis. There is one guy, amazing guy in Courtrai that gave me, well, don't gave me, I bought, and also thanks to him, I work with a very nice loom. Well, you know, it's because these fabrics that I had here on the left, I had them also at WIELS. So I was trying to do the same that I had at WIELS, but in a different way. I'm very happy to have done this. And even if I have felt in some moments very exposed, it's like a big exposure of me.
Would be by talking to Eva Gors, who is the person responsible for the WIELS Club and the residency program at WIELS.
And finally, there's also very important for us, the education and outreach program. So the residency program in particular, it's a space where I would say, well, a program that provides space and time for conception, creation and production. The residency provides working spaces and not only the actual studio space, which we consider more like a private space for the artists.
To be able to become operational. But anyway, without further ado, we have Cristina Redondo at the Academy of Rome. She's responsible for the residency art program there that's now actually hosting Gadea as a fashion scholar. Cristina, cuando quieras.
I want to thank you all for inviting us to this great experience, because Gadea has came to the Academy on March, so we are keen on seeing what she's going to do, because we have different ages, different disciplines, different visions of art, of life, and those things met together bring up new projects. Wait for you all at the Rome Academy.
Already going through WIELS. So Marta, please welcome, bienvenida. Why don't we go back from Rome? We leave Rome for a second, jet back to Spain. Tell us a little bit about Acción Cultural Española, about the wonderful residency program. Gracias, Marta.
Well, gracias, Sergi. Thank you for inviting ACE to be here. I'm just in charge of visual arts, architecture, and design, so there are, just to make sure to make the point of that. My question for you was very clear. I mean, how did this experience influence your career or your work? This experience as an artist in residency in WIELS.
This was the case of Gadea, and the fact that we never really demanded her or asked for a presentation at the end of a residency. It's a very interesting exercise that she had to do it she was invited to do it in the lab, in the embassy.
Muchas gracias, grazie tanti, gracias a todo el mundo, ha sido un placer. And now my colleague Irene is going to take us the way you all came into this little window. We're going to go out of the window and you're going to see the same perspective, but leaving us. Thank you all. Sorry for the 10-minute overlay. And thank you again for being with us. Gadea, continuamos. Un beso a
gracias.
Todos. Thank you for following us. Adios.
Thanks.